Whenever I see one of these brown non-glossy boxes, I know I'm looking at something a bit more enterprise level. Let's take a look. Hi everyone, Darren from Draytek Australia and New Zealand. Now at first glance you might assume that the Vigor2962 routers are just upgraded versions of the old Vigor2960 router. They're the same size and shape, and even the names are similar. However, a closer look reveals that these are better thought of as whole new products. The Vigor2960 was a dual-WAN router with 2 gigabit WAN ports and 4 gigabit LAN ports. If we look at the Vigor2962 series, we see 5 ports marked as WAN-LAN. That means they can either be WAN ports or LAN ports. Port P2 is shared with an SFP slot, meaning you can use either the RJ45 gigabit Ethernet port there, or the SFP slot if you have a direct fibre internet connection, or if you want to use it as a LAN port to uplink to a switch with either optic fibre modules and a cable, or using a DAC cable. DAC cables are a copper cable with SFP connectors at both ends. Draytek have the DAC CX10 cables available in either 1 or 3 meter lengths, which support anything from 1 up to 10 gigabits a second, making them a viable and cost effective solution over optic fiber. Next, you may notice port 1 is marked differently to the other ports. The reason for that is it'll support up to 2.5 gigabits per second instead of just 1. It also can either be LAN or WAN. And over on the right, we have 2 dedicated gigabit LAN ports. If we go to the web user interface, towards the top of the menu on the left, we see port setup. So here we can change ports 1 to 4 from WAN to LAN or vice versa. So if you wanted to use port 1 as a LAN port to take advantage of that 2.5 gigabits per second data rate there, or if you wanted to use the SFP port at P2 as a LAN port to uplink to a switch, for example, but you still need 2 gigabit WAN ports, you can then change ports 3 and 4 to WAN. What you can't do is have more than 2 WANs. If you try that, you get this pop-up telling you that's a no. We can also manually specify the speed we want each port to run at. Port 1, for example, we can leave at auto, or we can set it to either 2.5 gigabits per second or 1 gigabit per second or 100 or even 10 megabits per second. Port 2 and all of the other ports are 1 gigabit per second ports, and you can throttle those down to 100 or 10 megabits per second if you have a need to. The other physical change is that telltale blue inside USB port 2, indicating it supports the USB 3 standard. Both USB ports will allow connection of USB hard drives from firmware version 3.9.4, which is yet to be released at the time of this video. The difference between the USB ports is that the top one supports the USB 2 standard, which allows up to 480 megabits per second, while the bottom one can go up to 10 times faster at 4.8 gigabits per second, so keep that in mind when connecting a hard drive. Around the back we have an on-off button and a socket for an IEC power cable, so it has a built-in power supply like all good rack-mountable products should. Yes, it is rack-mountable, and rack mount brackets and screws are included. Also in the box is a power cable, an Ethernet cable, a product registration card, and a quick start guide. A full manual can be downloaded from our website, I'll leave a link to that below. There's also a leaflet explaining the terms of the general public license of the router's operating system. One other physical change is there's also another model in the Vigor2962 series called the Vigor2962P. The P stands for Power over Ethernet, which can power external devices like IP cameras and phones. It has a power budget of 60 watts, which it can put out on ports 1, 4, 5 and 6. Performance-wise, we've gone from 900 megabits per second in the Vigor2960 up to a massive 2.2 gigabits per second, which comes courtesy of a new hardware acceleration processor, which is enabled by default. IPsec throughput goes from 600 megabits per second up to 800 megabits per second, and SSL VPN throughput increases to 500 megabits per second, up from 300 megabits per second. And that's where these routers really stand out. Massive amounts of throughput to handle lots of concurrent VPNs. The Vigor2962 supports up to 200 PPTP, L2TP, IPsec, L2TP over IPsec VPNs, and up to 50 SSL or open VPNs. The Vigor2962 features high availability mode, which allows for a second Vigor2962 to be added to the network in a master-slave arrangement. In the event of the master unit failing, the slave unit will take over to ensure uninterrupted network access. Let's have a look at a couple of other features in the web user interface. First up, we see the usual Draytek dashboard, which gives us a summary of everything going on. In the graphic up the top here, we can see which ports are connected, and over on the right, we have some shortcuts to useful features. Up the top here, we have some more shortcuts. This second one will take us to a GUI map where you can see all of the configuration options on one page. Next, we have a web console option, which will open up a command window where you can enter telnet commands to alter some of the more advanced features. I'll include a link below to our knowledge base article with more information about that. Next one along, we can save a copy of the config, download the manual, it needs to be online for this link to work, and log out. Over at the top of the main menu, we can set the time it will automatically log out after a period of inactivity. If you're working on something complicated and that gets annoying, you can disable it by selecting off. That will then stay logged in until you log out. WAN General Setup, whichever ports you've set to WAN will appear here. Under each of these, you can enter line speed if your connection requires that, and enter a VLAN tag if your ISP needs one of those. Down the bottom, you can change between load balance and failover. Under Internet Access, you'll find options to connect to the internet using PPPoE or static or dynamic IPs. LAN General Setup, you'll find the usual details to change the subnet and DHCP details. Under VLAN, there's support for up to 20 with up to 20 LAN subnets. There's a hotspot web portal with up to 4 profiles. If I click into one there and change it to various hotspot login, there's options to require guests to log in using Facebook, Google, or a PIN, or with Radius. Then you can change what the landing page looks like and so on. Under VPN and remote access, if I go to LAN to LAN or remote dial-in user, we can create up to 200 profiles of each. Just bear in mind that even though you can technically create up to 400 profiles between these two options, only 200 will be able to connect at once. For the SSL and OpenVPN options, you can have a maximum of 50 simultaneously connected VPNs. Under VPN trunk management, you can load balance VPNs over 2 WAN links to add redundancy and/or increase VPN bandwidth. And under central management, we can manage 50 Vigor APs, and central switch management can manage up to 30 Vigor switches. In a future firmware update, we'll also see central VPN management added here. The Vigor2962 series can also be managed using the Vigor ACS2 or Vigor ACS3 central management applications. So that is Draytek's Vigor2962 series router range, which come with a 2-year backed base warranty. For more information about Draytek products, please check out our website at www.draytek.com.au. If you have any questions, please comment below or send us an email to sales@draytek.com.au or just give us a call on 02 9838 8899. Links below to the Vigor2962 series product page and to a test drive of the web user interface so you can check that out in more detail. Please like and subscribe below. Give the bell a click too if you'd like a notification of new videos as they go up. Thanks and bye for now.